So now let us start the exercise 2.2 of class 8 NCERT. Students, this is one of the largest exercise of the book, and there is so much to learn in this exercise that it cannot be covered in one video because it will become like 50 or 60 minutes video. So I will be keeping in parts. Okay, let's see how much part it will become. I have not prepared that way, but I will be giving you everything, every detail and every concept will be crystal clear to you. That is my main concept. Let it be two part, let it be three part, doesn't matter, but the concept will be clear. That's what matters. Okay, so first of all, students, you have to understand that in this exercise, in fact in any questions of linear equation, word problems of linear equation, what we need to do is we need to convert the English into mathematics. That is very important. Okay, like more, if we are saying, then that means it is plus. Like times means multiply. Okay, multiply with maybe fraction. Okay, so similarly, less means, of course, negative, minus. So this kind of abbreviations we will be using, and we will be decoding that English word into mathematics. So the first question says, if you subtract, so obviously subtract, we know, half from a number. Now a number they are using, so obviously this will be our x. Okay, that a number will be our x, and multiply the result by half, then you will get 1 by 8. Okay, you will get means what? You will get means what? We will be using that as equal sign. Okay, so let the number be x. So since this is the first question, so I am writing all the, you know, statements here. Otherwise, in the subsequent questions, I will not be writing all the statements, and you have to, you know, write the statements by your own. And I'll just giving you the equations, but of course wherever it is required, I'll be giving you the statements wherever there is a change. But for most of the question, it is the same way only. So you can write the statements by yourself. So now according to question, we need to subtract half from a number. That number we have taken x. So half will be subtracted from x. That is half minus x, x minus half, obviously. Okay. So in the next statement, they are saying that we need to multiply this result with half. So this is the result. Okay, this is the result, and we will be multiplying this with half. Understood, everyone? And now what we will get? We will get 1 by 8. Okay, so this is the equation we have formed by just decoding the English given in the question into mathematics. Okay, so we can solve this equation by using distributive property. Actually, there are two methods. I will be showing both the methods here. So first I have used distributive property, and I have multiplied each of the term with half and got this, and then I will be solving for x, like I've solved in 2.1 exercise, like this. Understood? I have kept x term here and the other terms here, and next step will be, okay, now the 2 will be transposed to that side of the equal. Understood? So what we will get here, the answer is, understood? Another method is there. It's not the method actually, it's just solving the same question in other way. That is, up to here it will be same, and after that solving method will change. Like this half we can directly put it, transpose to that side of the, this half we can directly transpose it to the other side because it is multiplied with the whole term. There is no addition or subtraction included here, so we will directly send it to this side. Okay, so it will be like this, and we get our equation as, now we will be solving for x and we will transpose half to that side. So what we will get, the answer will be same as the previous one. So I'm not showing this part here. Students, don't be shy. If you have any doubt in solving this part, I can make a video dedicated to this, solving this portion only, because the we have studied in class 6. Okay. And fraction chapter of 6 will be uploaded in the subsequent months in my channel. So it will take time. Okay, so if you need this, I can make a video for this. Please ask in the comment section. Therefore, the number is 3 by 4. Understood, everyone? Now let us proceed to question number 2 of exercise 2.2. In this, perimeter is given and a relation between length and breadth is given. Okay, so according to the relation, we will choose which one is to be taken as x. We can take any one of them as x, but the equation will be somewhat changed. Okay, so let's read the question. perimeter is given, and length is 2 more than twice its breadth. Okay, see, length, let me do this in rough for you. They are saying length is means equal. Okay, simple, equal is 2 meter more than, 2 meter more, so 2 will be added to something. So there is something here and 2 is added to that. And what is that something? More than twice its breadth. So 2 is added to twice its breadth. Twice means 2 into. Okay. So 2 into what? Breadth. Right. So twice its breadth and 2 is added. Then we get what? Length. So tell me, students, which one you need to take as x? Simple. If we take breadth as x, then our length will be 2x plus 2. Because length is twice more than 2 more than twice its breadth. Okay, so if we take breadth as x, that means length is equal to 2x plus 2. But if we take length as x, then we need to find the value of breadth, and that will be x minus 2 divided by 2. Of course, you can see that this will be leading us in a complicated scenario, and we will be having a complicated multiplication and addition in terms. Okay, so this will be a complicated calculation. And this will be, of course, easy. So we will take breadth as x and length as this. This part is not required. Okay. So let us take breadth be x meters. So we will have length will be 2x plus 2, right? Now, according to question, perimeter is given. So I put that in the given section. Perimeter is given. So perimeter formula is what, students? Since it is a rectangle, therefore perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into L plus B. Okay, so we'll just put the value of L and B into the equation and find the value of X. Putting all the values in the equation, and we will find X is equal to, understood the transposition method? So the answer will be 75 divided by 3, and that is equal to 25. So X is 25 meter. So what was X? It was breadth. That was 25 meter, and length will be 2 more than twice the breadth, that is 52 meter. See, students, you can recheck the value by putting length and breadth in the perimeter formula, and perimeter should be 154 meter only. Okay, understood? So let's proceed to the next question. In this question, it is given that the base of an isosceles triangle is given. So let this be the isosceles triangle in which base is given as 4 by 3 centimeter and perimeter is given as, that is 62 by 15. Now base is given and perimeter is given, we need to find the equal lengths of equal sides. Okay, so these are the lengths of equal sides. Now let us state that the length of equal sides be x. Okay, of course you have to write the statement. I will not be writing it here. I will do the equation. I will form the equation directly. According to question, we know that perimeter of any object is what, students? Sum of sides, right? Understood? So perimeter is sum of sides. Okay, so we can directly find the value of x from here. Okay, using transposition method, we get this fraction divided by 2, and simplifying this, we get the value of x as 7 by 5. That can also be written as 1 2 by 5. Okay, so the value of x is 1 2 by 5. That is the value of the sides, length of the equal sides. Student, always remember this important part, that is this statement you have to write in this word problem kind of questions. Okay, and never forget the unit. If you forget the unit, you'll lose half of your marks. So if you have understood the third question, let's proceed for the next question, that is question number 4. In this question, the sum of the two numbers is given, that is 95, and one number exceeds the other by 15. So there are two methods to solve this question, and I'll be showing both of the methods, but do not get confused by both the method. Okay, if you have understood one method, then leave the second method. Okay, so let's start the question by writing the basic things. So I have taken one number be x, and the other number will be automatically 95 minus x. Okay, so let me take x be the larger number, and so 95 minus x will be the smaller number. Okay, so to make it simple for the calculation, so according to question, let me do the first method. See, the first method is nothing but, it is given hidden in the question actually, sum is 95. So we have used that statement here. 95 minus x will be the other number if x is the first number. And if one exceeds the other by 15, that means nothing but the difference is 15 actually. So the difference is actually 15. And we will be subtracting the larger number minus the smaller number, which is equal to 15. Simple. Now we will be solving this equation and we will get our x value of x, that is the larger number, which we have got to be 55. So the smaller number will be 95 minus 55, that is equal to 40. Okay, so you have to write it here. Okay, therefore the larger number is, therefore the smaller number is, you have to write it separately. I have just shown here only. Okay, now if we are talking about the second method, that is actually decoding the English of the question into mathematics, that is one of the number exceeds by the exceeds the other by 15. So we will take both the numbers on the both side of the equal sign, and we know that this is larger and this is smaller. So 15 will be added to larger number or smaller number to make it equal? Tell me, students. Of course, 15 will be added to the smaller number so that the sum will be equal to the larger number. Understood? So this is smaller number, therefore 15 will be added to this number only. Understood, students? So we can directly get the answer that the larger number is equal to 55, and therefore the smaller number will be equal to 40, just like the previous method. Okay, understood? Both the method are very easy, both the method are simple, but you have to understand that if one number is greater than the other by 15, that means the difference is given actually. Sum is given, that is directly written in the question, but difference is also given, that is not directly written in the question, it is written in the another manner. So let's go to the next question, that is question number 5. In this question, two numbers are in ratio 5 is to 3 and their difference is 18. So this is very easy question, students. We will have to take the numbers be 5x and 3x. Okay, so in this way we can find the numbers. So obviously 5x is greater than 3x, therefore the difference according to the question will be 5x minus 3x, and that is given as 18. Very easy. So the x will be equal to what? 9. And we know that x is not asked. What is asked? The first number and the second number. So we will have to put the value of x there. That is 5 into 9. That is equal to 45. And the second number will be 3 into 9. That is 27. So now, students, you can see the difference is 18. So the answer is correct. So students, that's all for today. We will be covering the next questions of exercise 2.2 in the next video. Okay.